a real object, it's not a hologram. And if you look closely, you'll be able to see the three cables that hold it up. The sphere is made of carbon fiber, so it is a very light material. And even though it's about 6 feet tall, it only weighs about 50 pounds. When the image is on there, it does come from the four projectors around the corners of the room. So if you look around, you'll be able to see all of them. And so in other words, our sphere is a movie screen, just shaped differently from other movie screens you may have seen. Now we will start our tour of the solar system in the center of the solar system. So who knows what's at the center of the solar system?
The sun?
The sun, yes, the sun is at the center of our solar system. Now, this image of the sun, there are two satellites that are always taking images of the sun to keep us up to date on what it looks like. But these satellites are not quite far enough apart to get a complete picture of the sun. The sun is just still too big for those satellites where they are. And that's why there's a blank section of this image. There's no slice cut out of the sun in real life, but that's just the way our picture looks because of the way the satellites take that image. Now, the sun is very important to our solar system because of two things that it gives to all of the planets. Can you think of what the sun gives to all of the planets? Yeah.
Light and heat.
Light and heat, very good. Yes, the sun gives light and heat to all of the planets, and also all of the planets orbit the sun. So, does anyone know what it means to orbit? Yeah.
Spin around the sun.
Okay, yes. So, if I was going to show something orbiting the sun, I'd have it go around on a little track on this railing here, and that would be an orbit of our sphere. And now we will look at the planet that is closest to the sun. Does anyone know the name of this one?
Yes. The moon.
Okay, so think about this. The moon actually orbits the Earth. This is a planet that orbits the sun.
Mercury,
yes, this is the planet Mercury. Now, what do you see on the surface of Mercury?
Yeah, Mercury,
like the element. Okay, a good thought, but...
craters.
Yes, it's craters that we can definitely see on here. I'm not sure about the composition of Mercury's surface, but we can definitely see the craters here. And Mercury has all these craters, because Mercury does not have an atmosphere. So when a meteorite falls towards Mercury, it is not slowed down by passing through the atmosphere, and there will never be any weather to wear away those craters. Also, because Mercury does not have an atmosphere, this means that it cannot hold on to the heat from the sun when the sun is not shining on it. So, well, it does get pretty hot during the day on Mercury, about 800 degrees Fahrenheit. At night, that temperature drops to about negative 270 degrees Fahrenheit. And that's the biggest temperature difference between night and day of any planet in the solar system.
Venus.
Venus, yes. This is the planet Venus. Now, Venus is a lot different from Mercury because Venus has a very thick atmosphere that is mostly made of carbon dioxide, and so Venus can hold on to a lot of heat from the sun. So much, in fact, that even though Venus is far farther from the sun than Mercury. It is the hottest planet in our solar system, with its temperature remaining close to 900 degrees Fahrenheit day or night. Now, this image of Venus here, this is not what we would see if we looked at Venus through a backyard telescope. This is a radar image of Venus, and it is a topographical image, which means it helps us to understand the shape of Venus's surface. So the light-colored areas, those are the mountains and other high elevation areas on Venus. And then the darkest colored areas are the deepest areas on Venus. You may notice how there are a couple sections of taller areas near the equator, and sometimes those are referred to as continents, but unlike the continents of Earth, they do not have oceans between them. Now we definitely all know this one. You can say it all together. 1, 2, 3, it's
Mars!
Yes, the Earth. So, since you live on the Earth, you probably know a lot about it. So I'm going to give you all two clues for two things that make the Earth different from every other planet in the solar system. So here's the first clue. This stuff is what gives the Earth the nickname Blue Marble.
Yes, water.
Water, yes. So Earth has these large oceans of liquid water, and more importantly, in a planetary sense, Earth has liquid water all year round. So there's never any point in Earth's orbit where all of the water is frozen. All right, the second thing that makes the Earth different from every other planet in the solar system, we have 8 examples in this room right now. I think we have more than 8 oxygen molecules in this room right now.
Carbon.
We also have a lot more than 8 carbon atoms in this room right now, too. So we have 8 examples, yes.
Life forms.
Life forms, yes. So, Earth, as far as we have discovered, is the only location in our solar system with life on it.
Hey, you can't mess up Mars' orbit.
And we can see that there are two
or spin,
small
I meant.
White patches on Mars. So this must mean that Mars is going moldy. That's not what it means. So before I turned Mars on its side, these white patches were at the north and the south of Mars. So what might we have that's white at the north and south of the planet? Yes.
Snow.
Snow, yes. So these are Mars's ice caps. They are made of both regular water ice as well as dry ice which we know on Earth, or which is frozen carbon dioxide. Gaia is the common name.
You just reminded me of something about Venus that you didn't mention. Venus is the only planet that doesn't spin in the same directions as the others.
Oh yes, Venus does have a... on Venus you would see sunrises in the west and sunsets in the east. That's what that means. Now Mars has some notable planetary features. I'll reset this so we can see it in the right orientation. So, other things I want to point out. There is a very large crater on Mars called the Hellas Planitia. That's over here. And then, as we keep turning around, so you'll over there be able to see the Hellas Planitia now. Then we have what looks like a crack in the surface of Mars. Excuse me. That is the Valles Marineris. It is a canyon that is 4 miles deep, and if it was located on the United States, it would stretch all the way from California to New York. And then just a little above and to the left of the Valles Marineris, you can see Olympus Mons. Olympus Mons is the tallest mountain in the solar system, measured from base to peak, and it used to be a volcano. Six. Which one is this one?
about this, you know, Saturn.
Yeah, it doesn't have to rain.
It doesn't have the rain.
No,
there's lots of reasons to want to look at the rings. They're pretty cool, and they are the largest ring structure in our solar system, and so the easiest to see with a telescope. And they're made of rock and ice and dust, and they're actually only a few miles thick, which for something out in space, that is really like thinner than paper thin. But if we wanted to have the rings be the correct size for the size of Saturn, even the one closest to Saturn would be right outside the doors. So they would not fit in this room. Saturn itself, though, has a few interesting properties. For one thing, Saturn is buoyant. Anyone know what buoyant means?
Yeah, it floats.
It floats, yes. So if you've heard of a buoy is buoyant, so that's a way to remember it. So Saturn is of a density that would float in water. Now, Saturn also has a storm on it. Storm is at its north pole. So started over here, and then we'll move around. And when scientists observed this, they noticed that this storm was not the shape they expected it to be. So what shape is that storm at Saturn's north pole?
Looks like a hexagon.
It is a hexagon. And so, for the other storms that had been observed on gas giants, they'd all been circles or ovals. So seeing a storm with corners was pretty surprising. So that is actually something that scientists are still investigating to figure out exactly what combination of atmospheric conditions, maybe magnetic field conditions, would result in a storm shaped like a hexagon. Alright, here's planet number 7. Does anyone know the name of this one? Yeah.
Pluto?
Okay. Pluto is a dwarf planet, and we're actually still looking at gas giants right now. Did you hear you say it though? Yes, this is the planet Uranus. Now, I turned Mars on its side so we can see some interesting things about it. And I turned Saturn on its side so we can see some interesting things about it. But, well, the planet Uranus is actually tilted out in real life. So, most of the planets, they rotate kind of like spinning tops. Kind of like this. Earth, we have an axis, that's the imaginary line that goes through the center of the rotating object. Earth's axis is tilted at about 23 degrees. But Uranus' axis is tilted at 98 degrees. So, effectively, it is sideways compared to the other planets. And if we imagine the other planets as spinning tops, this one we should imagine as rolling around like a wheel. Also, because the planet is tilted, the rings it has are tilted as well. So if we see most pictures of Saturn with rings horizontal in that picture, well, if Uranus was also to be in the same picture, its rings would be more vertical. So, we don't yet know exactly why Uranus is tilted so far over, but it was likely a collision with a very large object that caused that tilt. Does anyone know this one?
Neptune.
Neptune, yes, it is Neptune. So, Neptune, as the farthest planet from the Sun, it is the coldest of the gas giants, and it's cold enough that its atmosphere, while still mostly gas, some of it is starting to cool down enough to form liquid. So it's sort of a slushy of gas and liquid that forms the atmosphere of Neptune. Now, I believe the storm that's on Neptune started over by your group is coming around close now. You'll notice it as a slightly darker spot with some lighter colored clouds above and below it. I hope that kid is okay. Back to Neptune. Neptune had a storm on it that was named the Great Dark Spot, but that storm is not there anymore. It only lasted about 30 years. And so, despite that it is still a gas giant, Neptune still has significantly different weather compared to another gas giant named Jupiter.
You know what's amazing to me? The people that, like, if you ask random people, try it. Just ask them, is the sun bigger than the earth? And half of the people will say, oh, the earth's bigger than the sun. But look at the size of the sun compared to the size of the earth. And people don't really think about it usually.
Science is fun!